بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I think it's time. أحب أبدأ بإني أهنيكم بالعشر المباركة. الله يتقبل منا منكم صالح الأعمال ووفقنا لكل خير. Good afternoon, everybody. It's really an honor and privilege to introduce Dr. Fawzia Al-Haymi, who is a member of the Pediatric Ophthalmology Division at the King Khalid Specialist Hospital. She will talk to us about a very interesting topic about prescribing glasses to children, the new trends. I'm sure you will find this very interesting and with a lot of really like, you know, first class, you know, information. And without any further delay, I would like to call on Dr. Fawzia to start her presentation.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Our presentation will be about the clinical practice guideline for prescription the glasses in children. I think this is important subject because we are facing with this problem in every day and every clinic. First, we will speak about the introduction. As we know, the refractive error is the most common cause of reduced visual acuity in children. It affects about 2 to 11% of population below 16 years. It's also responsible for 60 to 80% of visual impairment in the children. Prescription of glasses in children is not easy. It is challenges due to limited cooperation of the children and low reliability in the vision assessment, age-related immotorization, and risk of amblyopia. If refractive error was detected, we must take into account the visual need according to the age and the strong accommodative element, risk of amblyopia, age of immotorization, and associated condition as a strabismus before prescription of the glasses for children. Cycloplegic refraction is the most important, and this is the rule in the children due to presence of a strong accommodation. We will speak first about the refractive change in the children, immotorization. We know the cornea and the lens, as well as the axial lens, is formed the primary refractive component of the eye. The process by which the eye has coordinated the growth of its refractive component during early childhood to reach the refraction near blaenu is called ommetropization. At birth, most of infants are hyperopic plus 2, followed by period of slower phase of ommetropization until 2 years. Then at the 4 to 5, it will be shifted a little bit to the myopia. The rate of immotorization is usually proportional to the initial error. Those patients with higher immotropic show greater and faster change in the overall refraction. Most of this change occurred during the first year, and immotorization initially completely finished by the 6 to 7 year with a myopic shift. This table shows us the change in the parameter of the with the growth. In the axial length, it's about 17 millimeter at the birth. Then it becomes 23 in the adult. And keratometry, it will be 56 at the birth. Then it will decrease to the 43 in the adult. Lens power, it's 45 at the birth. Then it will decrease to 24 at the adult. Also, there is a higher risk, high prevalence of astigmatism at the birth. About 70% of full-term newborn having astigmatism, about 1 diopter or more. With the time, with the growing, it will decrease in the both in the prevalence and the degree in the of astigmatism in the first few years. Assessment of refractive error, as we told before, the cycloplegic refraction, it must be the rule in the due to presence of strong accommodation. It will reveal the refractive status of the eye with accommodation at the rest. We can do dry retinoscopy to give us rough idea about the refractive error of the child, and also to assess how the accommodative effort for this child. The gold standard is the retinoscopy for refraction. A new autorefractometer can give comparable results, but the problem with the autorefractometer, it can induce some proximal convergence that produce some accommodation. Also, it is difficult to convince uncooperative child to place the head on the autorefractometer. The handheld autorefractometer can help this problem, But still, the retinoscopy is the vital aid in calculating the accurate refractive error in children. Factor must be considered before prescription of the glasses. The refractive status in the beginning, we told they are usually the neonate are hyperopic, less than 4 diopter. Also with astigmatism, about 2 diopter, both of hypermetropia and astigmatism will reduce with age. So we must take into account the visual need of the children. A child less than 2 years has a minimal interest to the distant object, and they are, so the myopic correction is not needed as the near vision is still clear. But hypermetropia must be corrected earlier than the myopia. Risk of myopia depends also in the age of patient and magnitude and type of refractive error. As we told, myopia, the near vision is still clear, so it is less myopic than less amblyopic than hypermetropia. Anisometropia is the most common cause of amblyopia. The presence of astigmatism is play an important role to make decision to give glasses. We will describe the some rule for prescription for every refractive error. As we told, the hypermetropic, the children has a strong accommodation, and he can overcome the minimal amount of hypermetropia. Many studies show less than 1% of healthy children have hypermetropia more than 4 diopter. The plus five diopter become difficult to overcome. That means the patient needs to accommodate it with to see the near vision plus 8 diopter, which is can cause astigmatism. Amblyopia and isometropia, as we know, the outcome of uncorrected hypermetropia. Amblyopia, it occurs when the overcome hypermetropia, when the patient cannot overcome hypermetropia all the time, especially for near vision. Low amount of hypermetropia, it can cause the refractive accommodative azeotropia. In hypermetropia, if there is no ET, it is the rule the mild undercorrection can be prescribed to allow for accommodation to occur. Undercorrection should always equal in both eyes, as the accommodation is binocular phenomena. We are the amount of hypermetropia need to be correct depending on the age and the presence of ET. We have some guideline here. Infant less than 1 year, we will prescribe if the hypermetropia plus 6 with undercorrection plus 2. Infant from 1 to 2 years, we prescribe if it is more than 5 and we undercorrected plus 1.5. Preschool before less than 5, we prescribe if it's more than 4 and we undercorrected plus 1.5. The school age more than 5, we prescribe only if it is more than 1.5 in asymptomatic child. And the symptomatic, if even if it's less than 1.5, we will prescribe without under correction. We have here hypermetropia and special condition, like in patients with cortical visual impairment and developmental delay, they may not appreciate the improvement provided by spectacle and they will not tolerate them. On the other hand, the patient with a Down syndrome, they are usually hypoaccommodator and they have low accommodative amplitude, and they will get more benefit from less amount of the spectacle correction. We will discuss now the prescription rule for the myopia. As we know, the myopia is more common in the premature infant. Myopia less than 5 is less risky for amblyopia, as the near vision is unaffected. Infant only with a large amount of myopia need to correct. When the child is still start to grow and walk, he started to notice the farther object and his visual demand will increase. The aim of prescription is the lowest minus power needed for best visual acuity. The overcorrection will induce hyperopia that will overcome by accommodative effort, and the child will see the same line until the accommodation is become no longer sufficient. We can overcome this problem of overcorrection by dichromic test in older children, but in young children, the cycloplegic refraction, it gives us the least minus power for eye that needed. Some guideline for prescription, if he is less than 1 year, we prescribe if it's more than 5, and we undercorrect 2, minus 2. from 1 to 2 years, we prescribe if it is less than 4 diopter, and we undercorrect if it is minus, we undercorrected minus one. From 2 to 3 years, prescribe only if it is more than 3, and we undercorrect either 0.5 or 1. More than 5 years or 4 years, we prescribe if it is more than 1.5 or if there is a symptoms. We don't want undercorrection at this age because the patient become in the school age and he need the distance vision to be clear also. Myopic patient may have a near esophoria and larger lag of accommodation or shorter habitual reading distance. So we will give him +2 additional progressive lens. Rule for prescription in the astigmatism, the accommodation can change only the spherical refractive status of the eye by changing in the curvature of crystalline lens. Astigmatism cannot be overcome by accommodation, so the cylindrical power above the above two diopter can be embryogenic. Cylindrical power must be prescribed also depend on the age of patient. As opposed to the adult, the total cylindrical power can be prescribed even if it's high astigmatism, because the patient has easy to adapt, the children easy to adapt it for the glasses. Symmetrical astigmatism less than 1.5 diopter may be not corrected except if it's associated with high myopia or high hyperopia. Oblique astigmatism compared to the other type, it is more embryogenic, and so it must be prescribed even with even if it is 1 diopter. Rule of prescription, we will give partial correction until the age of 3 to 4 years by 1 diopter less. Spectacle fitness and centralization is extremely important in the higher cylindrical power. We must teach, explain for the father, for father and mother, the importance of centration. And when the children is bent their frame, and it must be rhombic repair and tightening to ensure benefit of the glass all the time. The thumb guideline, from less than 2 years, we prescribe if it's more than 2.5 with under correction, 1 diopter. If it's from 2 to 3, we will prescribe if it is more than 2 diopter and under corrected 1 diopter. If it is more than four years, we prescribe if it is more than 1.5 or if there is a symptoms and no need for under correction as the emmetropization at this age is completely finished. Rule of prescription in isometropia and anisometropia, the factor affecting the prescription of spectacle in anisometropia are anisoconia and embryopia. In case of anisometropia, the best correction for each eye must be assessed first, then the binocular correction is assessed also. And isometropia is more associated with embryopia, even with the lower error must be corrected. And hyperopia and the cylindrical and isometropia are more risky for embryopia than an isomyopia. In case of an isometropia with embryopia, first we will give the child the full refractive correction alone, and we will see some improvement. If complete improvement, okay. For visual acuity, no need for amblyopia treatment. If no complete improvement in visual acuity, we will start amblyopia treatment after 4 months. That will help us, the patient will be more compliant with the occlusion therapy after this period, because the visual acuity already improved in the, partially improved in the amblyopic eye. The older children may be unable to tolerate the full correction binocularly. So the correction of more emmetropic eye may be need to decrease even if visual acuity become suboptimal in that eye. A very large difference in the refraction between the eye, it's better to correct it with the contact lens. Some rule of prescription in anisometropia, if the patient have anisometropia with myopia, if he is less than 1 year, we will prescribe if it's more than 5 the difference. From 1 to 2 years, prescribe if it's more than 4. From 2 to 3 years, prescribe if it's more than 3. For hyperopia, the less than 1 year, prescribe if it's more than 2.5. From 1 to 2, prescribe if it's more than 2. From 2 to 3 years, prescribe if it's more than 1.5. For astigmatism, also If it's less than 1 year, we prescribe if it's 2.5. If it is from one to two years, or even up to 3 years, we can prescribe if it, the difference more than 2 diopters. We discuss now the special situation as post-cataract surgery. If the patient have unilateral aphakia, the problem we will face an anisocornea that will happen 20 to 25 with a spectacle correction, manifest strabismus, usually the ET in the younger children and XT in the older children, if aphakia persists for long time. Diplopia and bilopia, that is deprivation, and also strabismus and bilopia can happen. The correction is usually better with the IOL or contact lens, with the near correction plus 2.5 to plus 3 if the aphakic eye that will be used for the near work. Also with the treatment of bilopia and strabismus. In the bilateral aphakia, the correction of bilateral aphakia is best to done by either glasses or contact lens. The contact lens has a significant advantage over the glasses in this situation, but risk of infection, training of the family, and the cost factor limit its use and make the aphakic glasses the alternative using. Retinoscopy can be performed even without cycloplegic because the eye is already aphakic. We will add plus two or plus two to plus three in the spherical, in the glasses in the beginning, before when the patient is less than 2 years, then later on we will separate it to bifocal when the patient starts to walk and he needs the distance vision also to be clear. Executive bifocal at the level of the pupil, it's the peripheral one for children. We will discuss in the cases of strabismus. Usually the role of glasses in the strabismus with a refractive error is to relax accommodation in ET and to exert some accommodation in XT. So hypermetropia with azotropia, it must be corrected even if it's less. If it's 1.5 diopter, it must be completely corrected. Children need the correction more than 5 diopter, or older children, older child that wearing the glasses for first time may be difficult to adapt for the glasses. It will need a few weeks to accept the correction. Usually the moderate hypermetropia is the one responsible for accommodative azotropia. If it's between 2.5 to 5, it can be cause accommodative azotropia. While the higher hypermetropia, they are not causing because the accommodative effort is high, higher cannot be done for this high power. In intermittent exotropia, as we know, the intermittent exotropia is its loss of fusion for brief period. During that, the eye is deviated out. We prescribe the concave glasses to induce some convergence and reduce the frequency of azotropia. There is a general rule to prescription or in the XT. Any refractive error due to the visual acuity must be corrected to improve the fusion. Small amount of myopia cannot be not needed to be corrected. Hypermetropia with the normal visual acuity, no need to prescribe because it will reduce the convergence. Hypermetropia that reduce the visual acuity, it cannot prescribe, but with under correction. Now a patient with high ECA ratio, as we know, the children have ET. The ET at the near is more than ET at the distance, more than 15 prism diopter, considered as high ECA ratio. We have a two method to exactly measure the ECA ratio, the gradient method and hyperheterophoria method. First, we must see the importance of, we must show the effect of the full cycloplegic distance correction on the deviation by prescribing single vision glasses. Then if the distance deviation only reduced to the small amount and not become orthophoria, less than 10 prism diopter, we need to interfere either with the surgery or Botox. We will not add bifocal. If cycloplegic distance correction can correct the distance deviation and it become less than 10 prism diopter, we can add the bifocal at this time. The bifocal we add plus 2.5 or to plus 3. Later on, we will reduce depend on the response of the child. The bifocal should be executed style with the reading segment bisect the pupil. This we will be ensure the child will start to use the segment, the near segment with minimal depression of the eye. And anisometropia with amblyopia, the accommodation, as we told, it's equal and symmetrical in both eye. So the fixing eye determine the amount of accommodation and the amblyopic eye lagging behind. The accommodation cannot be expected to exert to compensate for unequal refractive error by unequal activity. Also, the amblyopic eye usually has less accommodation than the normal eye. For the treatment of anisometropia, we will start with cycloplegic refraction. Then after 12 weeks, we will see if the patient, if the visual acuity improved completely, okay, no need for amblyopic treatment. If still there is a difference in the visual acuity, we will start the amblyopia treatment. Sometimes the children with the high hyperopic correction cannot tolerate it from the beginning. We are symmetrically decrease the plus in the power in both eyes symmetrically. We will discuss now the spectacle characteristic of the glasses for the children. As we know, the spectacle frame for children should be designed differently from the adults, paying attention to the important morphological difference and characteristic pediatric facial feature. We will, there is a several important factor. First, the material. The ideal frame should be strong but flexible, traumatized, and can absorb the impact, and avoiding sharp edge or corner to minimize possible injuries effect. The children is more, as we know, it's more physically active than the adult. The glasses may be secured to the head, either with the strap or with the flexible air base. Regarding the optical, we must be sure that the stability and poor centration through the support of the upper part of nasal pyramid. Frame fitness, the spectacle frame should be of proper size and should be have a basic requirement. We can check if the spectacle frame is good or not by simple test, named 4-point touch test. All point of the spectacle frame, 2 points from the each side of eye wire and one from each temple must be touch the flat surface simultaneously. This is explained here. This point, and also this point, and this point must be touched the flat surface simultaneously. That means the frame is okay. Regarding the material, we are using polycarbonate glasses. Ideally, all the glass in children must be from the polycarbonate material because it is shatter resistant, and also it has inherited property of UVA protection. But the disadvantage, this material is so expensive. So we are prescribed this for the single eye patient or patient with a vitreous eye, like in case of monocular amblyopia or corneal injury. It also must be prescribed for the sporting activities to avoid an inadvertent eye trauma. Also, we will speak tint glasses and photochromatic glasses and ultraviolet protection. Usually the tint and photochromatic glasses not routinely prescribed for the children because they are affecting the visual contrast while indoors. The children with the photophobia as albinism and iridia, coloboma, corneal scar, are prescribed the glasses with the dark tint, about 80 to the 90% for outdoor, and less tint for indoor, from 20 to 30%. And the presence of tint without UVA protection is harmful because the untinted it's more harmful than untinted glasses because the tint causes dilation of the pupil and allow more light to enter the eye without, and that if there is no UVA protection, it will causes UVA damage and more dangerous. Thank you very much.